I wear in good dictator of great country of China. I wear win Taiwan. I wear control entire source China Sea. I wear make weapon so big that they will tremble with fear. Okay, I know China do not have electricity much, but come on, what are these people and what are their sins company for? I will cut their right and use power, make big weapon. I will biggest missile and run shit everywhere. Even Mao Zedong will be smarter man than me.
And welcome to TFI Global, the foreign affairs and geopolitical analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I'm your host Atul Mishra, and in this video I will tell you how China is got least prepared for a war. A great power crisis is ravaging China for the last few months now, and the world is still foolishly blaming it upon the so-called coal crisis. Till now you have been told what the Communist Party of China wants you to hear. It wants to propagate how China is risking its enormous wealth and economic development just to shift away from the conventional sources of energy towards cleaner fuel. However, the truth is exactly the opposite and even terrifying for the rest of the world. China could be preparing to unleash a war on the world in the shadows of the crippling power crisis, even as its economy takes a massive hit due to the CCP's latest misadventure. But first of all, let me bust the myth of the so-called power crisis in China. Let us look at the data on electricity production in China. The energy production in China has remained higher than the year 2019, when the pandemic had not even surfaced. From January to August, power production in China has grown by 11.3% on a year-on-year basis and by 11.6% when compared to the same period in 2019, effectively an average growth rate of 5.7% per year over the last 2 years. Even in August this year, 738.3 billion kilowatt hours of electricity were generated, which means a year-on-year increase of 0.2%. Data also shows that while the electricity growth rate of most individual energy sectors, thermal, nuclear, wind and solar power, has slowed, the amount of energy produced has only been increasing. Hence, it won't be justifiable to say that China is not producing enough energy to keep its wheels running. However, neither the Chinese homes nor the Chinese industries are getting their fair share of this massive production. So where exactly this great amount of electricity produced is being diverted? What exactly is China hiding from the world and its own people, who have been left to fend for themselves amid the surging pandemic and a gruesome economic crisis? An Epoch Times report suggests that China's third-tier military industrial enterprises are the most likely benefactors of large-scale energy production. The report also reveals that despite electricity rationing in most tier 1 cities of China, the regions having dense military industries have largely remained powered. China has moved its main arms production unit to a mountainous region in central China, where it could be diverting a large share of the energy. Given the fact that the production of nuclear arms, missiles, and other military products require a great amount of energy, the Chinese households and industries have been conveniently rendered powerless. Hence, it is highly likely that the CCP itself has engineered this power crisis in its cities to give the world an impression that it is committed to reining in its carbon emission and to contributing towards a cleaner planet. On the contrary, China is shamelessly laying the ground for waging a war on its enemies by ramping up its defense production. This also shows how the CCP and the People's Liberation Army, or the PLA, are hardly prepared to take on any military challenge in the near future. The CCP today faces unprecedented challenges at home. It is the most disliked regime in the world, with people growing more resentful with each passing day. The energy crisis, which has engulfed the nation for months now, has only aggravated the situation for the CCP. The crisis has taken a massive toll on the Chinese economy. With a dire economy and a surging pandemic, the Chinese people are increasingly growing impatient with CCP's tyrannical rule. The ire carries an existential threat for the CCP. But even that is a risk worth taking for the Chinese ruling elites. Today's PLA is structured to deal with unarmed rivals at home. However, as China faces the heat at the mountainous Indo-Tibet border in the Himalayas, as it inches towards realizing its Taiwan unification dreams, the CCP is suddenly forced to arm the PLA with enough arms and weaponry to take on battle-hardened army like that of India or Japan. Hence, it's not the Australian coal or Russian gas that is driving the massive energy crunch in China, but it is actually the megalomaniac policies of President Xi Jinping. China's energy crisis is purely a CCP-made crisis, orchestrated to mislead the world so that it can catch its enemies off guard and at their weakest. However, with its inefficient and pampered military, it wouldn't be long before they receive a nice drubbing of their lifetimes, even after getting armed with brand new weapons being hurriedly produced in China's power-hungry defense industries.